28th Summer University Games from Gwangju, Korea, Day 3. There's the Kim Dae-jung Convention Center, the site of the International Broadcast Center, the main media center, and fencing. In today's highlights, we'll take a look at last night's men's and women's team all-around competition. We'll also look in on Brazil and the United States in men's basketball. We'll move as well to the water, where Canada takes on China in women's water polo action. And finally to the court, where the Canadians will take on Russia in a battle of men's volleyball. Men's and women's artistic gymnastics from last night at the Gwangju Women's University here in Gwangju. This is the team final. We will first take a look at Oleg Vernayev on the pommel horse. Vernayev is a very decorated Universiade athlete, having won 3 medals in Kazan, a silver in team, a bronze in the all-around, and a bronze on the parallel bars. He also won gold in the parallel bars at last year's World Championships. Always an incredible demonstration of strength and balance by these athletes on the horse. And the Ukrainian here doing a wonderful job trying to put his team in position to medal. And there is his dismount, a very solid performance for Vernayev, a score of 15.100. Now this is Naoto Hayasaka of Japan on the men's floor exercise as part of this team final. He too trying to find a way to get Japan in medal contention. Hayasaka attends the Judento University in Tokyo. Tokyo, the site of the 2020 Summer Olympics. Another tumbling pass here for Hayasaka. Solid landing there on that one. You can see he's really excited about that performance, and he should be. A score of 15.550 for Hayasaka. And that helped put Japan currently in first place. Now Chen Yu of China, this is his second attempt on the vault. Scored a 15.500 on his first. Ooh, a little bit of a step back on that landing. But still enough to score him 15.300. Now look in on the high bar. This is Lee Hyuk-jung of Korea. He competed at last year's World Championships, placing 22nd in the men's all-around and 46th in the high bar. And there you see him gearing up now for his dismount. There it is, and he sticks that landing very well, but did appear to pick up a bit of an injury. He will score a 14.350. We now look at Ekaterina Kramarenko of Russia on the uneven bars. She's a former Olympian herself, having competed at the 2008 Beijing Olympics, finishing 4th in the team and 5th in the floor exercise. She was an alternate in Kazan at Universiade in 2013. Russia in very good position here in the women's team to place in top spot, and this will help Solid dismount there from Kramarenko. She'll score a 14.800. We now go to Natsumi Sasada of Japan. Her performance on the beam. She won the 2013 and 2014 Japanese National Championships all around. Japan right now in second spot, trying to catch the Russians. Korea is currently in third place. And a really solid dismount there from Sasada. And that will help give Japan a silver medal. Russia with a score of 165.500 takes gold, and Korea will claim the bronze medal. Basketball action from the Dongkang College Gymnasium here in Gwangju is Brazil taking on the United States. Brazil beat Chile 78-33 in their opener, while the United States beat Turkey 66-57 in their first game. Right now, 10-9, the Americans ahead. And George Torres left open up top. He'll knock down that three-pointer, putting Brazil up by two. There's Nicholas Moore for the U.S. Almost stolen away, and then a big scramble for the ball. Some pushing and shoving here, as you'll see players having to be separated away. And a little bit of blood there on the face of Lucas Dias of Brazil. Here is Guillermo Pereira. That take is missed. And the Americans come back the other way. And eventually they will find Wayne Selden for a long three, and he knocks that one down, putting the Americans back up in front. Now 30 seconds to go here in the first half. A little step back jump shot there for Frank Mason. And the Americans start to stretch their lead. Now in the third quarter, here is Santo do Espirito. That little jump hook won't work. Perry Ellis for the U.S. picks up that ball and finds Selden for the huge finish. Wayne Selden with authority there. You'll get a good close-up of it here. There's the pass from Ellis. And right in your living room, Selden with the slam. Brazil now down by 12. They'll work the ball back up top. That is Pereira for three. Trying to keep the Brazilians in this one. Move now to the fourth quarter. Steal there for Derek Ramos, and a nice reverse finish for him. Brazil now down by 13. Under a minute to go. Here's Mason. He'll kick it into the corner, and Vic with the three-pointer, and that should ice it. U.S. up by 10. And with a couple free throws at the buzzer, it is over. The United States defeats Brazil to move to 2-0. Brazil falls to 1-1. There you see the final score. Americans now play Chile in their next game, while Brazil will move on to take on Switzerland. Women's water polo action on the slate here today in Gwangju from the Yeomju Indoor Aquatic Center. It is Canada taking on China in Group A action. Canada comes in 2-0, having defeated Serbia and Russia, while China is 1-2 with losses to Russia and Japan and a win over Serbia. Canada in the white caps, China in blue. Here early in the first quarter of play. And there's Kyra Christmas. She'll find Kelly McKee to get Canada on the board. They're ahead 1-0. China, though, will come back as they will work the ball up top in front of the goal. Looking for that decent shooting lane. Still can't quite find it. But Lin Lin will skip one home there to knot it at one. And they'll skip ahead to the fourth quarter. Canada with a 9-3 lead over China. Canada will work the ball here to Haley McKelvey, and she'll make no mistake there, putting Canada up 10-3. McKelvey had three goals in this game, and she is also a member of the Canadian national team. There you get a look at Canadian head coach David Perrodello, and he's happy with that one. Kyra Christmas here will fend off that defensive attack from China, but a great little floater, and she will plot her fourth of the afternoon to put Canada up 11-4. Christmas with 13 goals so far here in the tournament on only 18 shots. Chinese coach Li Wenhua not overly thrilled with where this one is going. But Lin will try to keep China in it. She'll put that one past Canadian keeper Coulter John. That'll make it 11-5 with just over 3 minutes to go. But China will run out of time, and they will fall to Canada 11-5. Kyra Christmas with four goals, as you see her there, number seven. Four goals to pace Canada here. There you see the standings. Canada at 3-0, China falls to 1-3. Men's volleyball action here at Gwangju, the Yeomju Gymnasium, the site for Canada and Russia. Canada 0-2, coming off losses to Iran and Thailand, and Russia 2-0 after having defeated Switzerland and Thailand. We move now to set point in the second set, and Kliuka is blocked by Coleman, and Canada knots it up at 24. You see Canadian head coach John Barrett. Now Byron Katurakis to serve. And the setup for Maxim Zhigalov. That one goes off the Canadian block and out. Russia up by one. Now to serve for the set. And Canada cannot get it through the block of Filipov and Zhigalov. And Russia comes back to win the second set, 26-24. Now to the third set, Russia up 9-5. Sergei Nikitin with the serve, not handled very well by Ryan Nikifor of Canada. Russia moves her advantage to 5. Now Russia up 4. Here's Zhigalov with a hard serve, and again, that one cannot be controlled by the Canadians. Russia continues to lead. 23-19, here's Coppers to serve for Canada. He'll get one back there with the ace. Canada down by 3. Now at match point, Coppers on the attack for Canada. He'll go off the Russian block and out. Canada stays in it. But now Russia, they'll set up Zhigalov from the back row, and he'll make no mistake to finish it off. Russia wins this match 3-0 and moves to 3-0 in the tournament. Canada falls to 0-3.